Hi guys, in this video I'll show you how to construct a cycloid in AutoCAD 2007. Supposingly this is our question. A circle of 50 mm diameter rolls along a straight line without slipping. Draw the curve traced out by the point P on the circumference for one complete revolution of the circle and name the curve and also draw a tangent to the curve at a point on it 40 mm from the baseline. This is the baseline which he is talking about. See, we can see here it is one complete revolution only, it is not a half or two times, it's only one complete revolution. And name the curve is also given because information regarding it is given in the first line itself. A circle of 50 mm diameter rolling along the straight line without slipping. That means that this curve is a cycloid. So this is the question how it will be given in the general exam point of view. Now coming to the AutoCAD version. So once you open the AutoCAD 2007, this is how it looks like. Then generally we go for the limits. Limit 0 comma 0 and press enter, and 500 comma 500 enter. Then take the units as usual. It is in millimeter. Okay, good. Okay. Now check the zoom all. You do zoom all. Now the screen is ready for us to start. Generally, we can check the settings also. Okay, these are all in the on position, so there is no problem. And we have draw toolbar, modify toolbar, and dimension toolbar and properties toolbar. These are enough for drawing it. So once you take the circle command and draw a circle with how much radius, it is 25 radius because the diameter is given as 50 in the question. Here the diameter is given as 50 mm. So first I have drawn the circle here. Once the circle is drawn, then select a line command, L enter, and from the base you should draw a straight line. This one should be straight, so I am pressing R though, and this one should be of length. We don't know because this length is not given. The length is how much? It should be calculated from the question. What is that? It is 50 mm, except that nothing is given in the question. Therefore, what we have to do? We have to use the calculator. We have to use the calculator. It is circumference, that is pi d, that is pi into d is how much? 50. 50 is equal to 157.07. This is the value. So we will take approximately 157 mm. So this line should be of length 157. We did get from the value that pi d or 2 pi r value. After that, complete a rectangle here. So for rectangle, it will be this is 50 mm, and close this at this end point, and this one also close it. So basically, we have drawn a circle of diameter 50, and we have constructed a rectangle along its diameter with one side is 50 mm and another side is 157 mm. That 157 is obtained from the value pi d, that is circumference of this generating circle. Now this is your baseline, this one is your baseline, and this is your generating circle. Once this is finished, select this line and use array command. Use array command. This is your array command. In that you use polar array, and already object is selected. Now if not, we can select again. Select that, and object is this line, and press enter. And center point is this one, the center point of the generating circle, this one. And instead of 4, I'll select 12. This means that I am basically dividing the circle into 12 equal parts. Now select a line along this points, draw straight lines up to this end point. Repeat it at all the other points also. If you observe carefully, when you are drawing from one line, automatically the other point is also meeting it here. So you need not draw two separate lines for this line and this line. Only one line is enough for both the points. Similarly, from this point, we'll draw another line up to this one, which is nothing but the midpoint one. This is this one. From here also, we can get it from this. This is the way how you draw the base thing. After this is finished, we can give the names, like this is your point P as given in the question, like this one, point P. So this is your point P. Empty enter. I can give the point here. You can change the size to some 3. I'm changing it. I'm giving something. This is point P. Okay. So this is your point P. Once point P is given, remaining things also you can give something like 1, 2, 3, 4. In that way, you can give here. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In that way, you can give. And how many number of divisions you did in the circle, those many number of divisions you should do for the baseline also. If you are doing it in conventional method, we will do it for the center line basically. But since this is being done in AutoCAD, this process will be easy for you. So we'll select this line, and before that we'll press DIV enter, division enter, and select this line and divide it into how many equal parts. We have to enter the number of segments as 12. because we have already divided the circle into 12 equal parts. Now division is done, but it is not visible to us. For that sake, what you have to do, we have to use format and go to the point style and change the point style to something else and then press OK. You can see the 12 divisions on the baseline. Now what we will do is that you do take your dimensioning, linear dimensioning option, and from P up to the first point, check the dimension how much it is there. Here I have got 13.08. Here I have got 13.08. So now I'll select this circle. I'll select this circle and use array. Instead of polar array, I'll go for rectangular array. Rectangular array. I don't want any rows, only one row is enough. I want columns as 13 columns. One second, it has some error here. So I'll select that and select it. Rectangular array, one row and 13 columns. And offset for the row is 1 and offset for the column is 13.08, as in here this point. Then okay, you can see here you have 13 circles which are obtained, which means that at each and every point at this point the circle is touching. You can see here, if I'm selecting this one and this one, both this point and the circle are touching here. Similarly, that means that the circle is rotating like this in the clockwise direction, and this P, what happens is that it will travel along this direction and it will come back up to this point, and at this point the P again touches here. So if this is P, this one also becomes P. If this is P, here we will get again P out. So we can change it to P dash. Let me say this is P dash. So P will go travel along this direction and come again here and touch here at the P. Now it is looking little clumsy, right? For that sake, what I will do, I will draw only half of this thing and remaining half I will do mirror image, so that I will not get any confusion. Then while doing the array itself, we could have gone for, instead of 13, we could have gone for 7. But if you are doing so, we don't know if you are doing any mistake, you can't find it out. But in this case, you can see here, when I have given the 13.08 and 13 circles, you can see the last circle is exactly half inside and half outside, which means that our diagram is perfect. Now what you will do is that you select this one and delete, because we don't want to get confused by all this. So last 6 circles you delete it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Last 6 circles I have deleted. Instead you can also go this way also. While you are doing array itself, you can go for columns as 7 and 13.08 and you can go half itself. But why I have finished 13 is that I want to check if I am doing correctly or not. For that sake I have drawn this. Now what you will do is that select the first circle and first line. Not the base circle and baseline. So this is your baseline. This is your baseline and this is your base circle or generating circle. I am not asking you to select these things. I am asking you to select the first line and first circle. These two I am asking you to select and go to the properties toolbar and give some color, assign some color. In the same way, second line and second circle you select it and give some separate color. Yellow I have given in this case. Third line and third circle, give some other color. Similarly, fourth line and fourth circle, give separate color. Fifth line and fifth circle, you give separate color. And the sixth line and sixth circle will be giving some separate color. Six colors I have assigned here. The reason is that you will know easily which point which should be selected. What is the intersection point which should be selected will be. Now select PO enter, that is point selection. For the red line and for the red circle, you give the intersection point here. Repeat it for the yellow and yellow, and repeat it for the green and green, repeat it for the cyan, repeat it for the blue, and repeat it for the magenta and magenta. If you observe carefully, it will be exactly at the midpoint itself. So we have obtained the 6 points where the things are to be, or the intersection points are there. That means this circle, whatever the P is there, when it is rotating, when this circle is rotating, this P point is being shifted from here to this point. When you go to the yellow circle, it will come here. When you go to the green circle, it will come here. When you go to the cyan circle point, it will come here. When you go to the same thing, it will go here. When you go to the halfway, that is 157/2, at this halfway, it will go from this point to opposite direction, this point. So you observe this point is the new P here. So we can give the names as P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6. So that this is the traveling of the path of the point P, we can say like that. So now what we can do is that select a polyline command from this point P, this first point, second point, third point, fourth point, fifth point and sixth point, up to this point you can draw, escape, and give poly edit command, PE enter, and select this one and use fit option to fit the curve, and select this one and give some line weight. Some I am giving some 60 line weight here. For it to be displayed, we should press LWT button here. It will be displayed here. Now once this is done, you can select this, use mirror option and from this midpoint to the midpoint, if I draw and press enter, the total curve is obtained. Now the important point is that the cycloid is finished, but the question is not finished because he has asked us to draw the tangent of the curve at a point on it from the 40 mm from the baseline. Okay, if this is the case, now we need to know what is the 40 mm distance from the straight line. For that, what we will do is that we will use offset command, and this is the base point, right? So select offset distance. What is that? 40 mm is the offset distance, and press enter. And this line, this is the baseline above which we want. So I'll select this line, and along this side I want. So I'm pressing the mouse button this side. So this is the line which is 40 mm from the baseline. So here we have the intersection point. I'll do one thing. I'll press the line weight button again so that intersection point can be obtained easily. Now PO enter, and this is our intersection point. This is our intersection point. Now since this line is not necessary, I can delete it. If you want, dimensioning can be given, like this linear dimension can be given. From this point to this line, it is 40 mm, which is given in the question. That is how you can give it. Later on, now what you have to do is that since the generating circle is of diameter 50, at this point also you select a circle and draw with 50 mm diameter, that is 25 mm radius. So 25, enter. Now when you are drawing this 25 mm radius, you can see that the central line passing through the center of this generating line, that line and this circle is being cut at this position. So select that PO and press enter and select this point. Observe carefully, I am talking that this is the central line. This is the central line. Along that central line, this whatever the circle now drawn will be cutting it at a point. That point is to be pointed out. So here we got that point. Once that is finished, I don't want this circle. So I'll do one thing. I'll select this circle and I'll delete it. Basically, what is the meaning is that from this point to this point, the distance is 25 mm. So if you are drawing traditionally on paper and paper, I would have said that select this point as center and 25 mm as radius, cut the arc on the center line in that way, I used to have said. But since it is the AutoCAD version, I am saying you to take circle and draw this circle and get this point. Once this point is obtained, select the line command, and from this point, draw a straight line until to the baseline, perpendicular line. Once this is finished, from this point, if you draw a straight line until the point which you have selected in the curve, this becomes the normal, and anything perpendicular to this will become the tangent. So for the getting the tangent, what I'll do is that after drawing this, again on this only I'm drawing another straight line, which means that two normals I have drawn on one another. Now I'm selecting that and using rotate command, and at this as my base point, I'm rotating it with 90 degrees. See, now I'll select this line and I'll change this. I'll select use move command, or I can directly select this midpoint and keep it here. So that whatever this point is there and this line is there, one is tangent and another one is normal. Again, for this also I'm giving line weight, and totally I'm pressing line weight option. So this is your total curve, this is your tangent, and this is your normal which is obtained. It's very simple. If you have not caught up with the tangent, just rewind it and play back again. It's very simple. We need to select the point first. After that, we'll select the point on the center line. From there, we'll draw the straight line to the baseline. From there, we'll draw a line that is normal, and for that perpendicular, whatever it is there, it is tangent. Now, once this is all finished, you'll write the, you'll use multi-text command. You'll write whatever the details you want, like cycloid and other things. And here, the dimensions which are to be given is diameter of the circle is known. So first, diameter should be shown definitely. Diameter is 50, and second information is regarding this one, that is also to be shown, 40 mm. And third information is that we have calculated the value of 157, that is from this point to this point we have calculated it is 157. So 157 should be shown, along with it should be written also here that pi d is equal to 157, that is the length of this line. Pp dash is equal to 157 is equal to pi into d, that should also be written here. With that, the diagram is finished. Now if you want to take a printout of this, then what we'll do, we'll select all this thing. If you're using a color printer, okay. If not, what you'll do, you go for black and white combination only. Don't go for all colors, because in some printers, you don't get the colors like good. So we'll give all this thing as a single color, and Z enter, E enter, everything is fit. Then go to the layout. Once layout is done, you can get it like this. You go to the file, you go use plot. You change the paper size to ISO A4 297 by 210 if you want to print it on A4 paper, then apply to the layout. Then just click cancel and see if the diagram is exactly fitting the black box. The black box is not correct, so once I'll select this and I can change it to my required specifications. I can move it there and here like this, and even I can zoom in and zoom out in here in this situation also. I'll do that one also. After this is finished, you take your mouse pointer inside, double click it here, then the black box will be highlighted. Then you can use the mouse wheel to zoom in and zoom out like this. You can even move by using pan option. So once this is all finished, okay, well and good if it is okay, then I can go to the file, plot, and instead of none, if I go to the PDF, drawing to pdf.pc3 and press OK, wherever I want, I can save it in that. I can use the name cycloid and use the same. So this is how you finish the cycloid along with its tangent and normal in the AutoCAD 2007 version. Bye.